Hello and welcome. First up news from South Asia. Former Pakistani Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif, his daughter Maryam and her husband Captain Safdar have been granted bail by the Islamabad High Court. The court suspended the Avonfield reference verdict, granting 10 years in jail to Sharif and 7 years each for Maryam and her husband Captain Safdar. The court has ordered their immediate release. Soon after the verdict, the supporters of Nawaz Sharif were seen shouting slogans outside the court in celebration of the verdict. All right, my colleague Anas Malik joins me live from Islamabad. Anas, good evening. Why did the court suspend their jail terms? And also, very importantly, does it reinforce suspicion that everything was scripted by the powers that be to keep Nawaz Sharif out of the electoral equation and prop up Imran Khan in the elections?
Absolutely, Ramesh. This verdict does reinforce that narrative of Pakistani deep state, particularly employing all of this to keep Nawaz Sharif away from the elections and getting a cleaner ground, a clearer ground for Imran Khan, the likes of Imran Khan and his own PTI as well. Because before the election, we saw a lot of discussions about that the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf had been backed by the Pakistan's powerful deep state and the military establishment. Now the verdict has been suspended on the grounds that the initial verdict by the accountability court was set out in rush and it did not hold much evidence that Nawaz Sharif was indeed the beneficial owner and that those trust deeds did belong to Maryam Nawaz Sharif. The prosecution, the National Accountability Bureau, failed to prove its charges in front of the Islamabad High Court when the Sharif family had challenged the verdict. So the two-member bench of the Islamabad High Court has scrapped this verdict and suspended it for the time being until a formal hearing is done. The National Accountability Bureau, however, has decided to challenge this verdict in Pakistan's topmost Supreme Court. Yes, Ramesh.
And very quickly, Anas, what next for the Sharifs themselves and the PMLN? Because before the election, there was a lot of talk about how this election was a fixed match, a rigged match. So what next, politically speaking, for the Sharif family and the PMLN?
Well, the next is that they have Pakistan has by elections on those seats that have been relinquished by those member elects who had been holding one or more, who had been elected on one or more constituencies, more than one constituencies. That is to happen in October, on October the 4th. So right after Nawaz Sharif is bailed out, once his bail orders are formally released by the jail authorities at Adyala Jail, he'll then be put on a plane for Lahore, a special plane, as his brother has informed the media, and then he'll be taken to Lahore. Initially, what we understand is that he'll be made to spend time with his family for about 2 to 3 days, and then he'll be going back to those active political ground and taking part in active politics and campaigning for his candidates in those by-elections that are to be taking place on the 4th of October here in Pakistan. So it will definitely be a moral booster for the Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz, and it would definitely be coming as a shock for the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf, because now they would be having some serious competition as far as competition on ground, because Imran Khan would be having an opponent who would be giving him a lot of tough time when it comes to ground politics. Yes, Ramesh.
Right, a morale booster for the Sharif family and a shot in the arm for the PMLN, says Anas Malik in Islamabad. Anas, on that note, thank you for that update. Appreciate it.